I didn't even make the first step, Davidson remembered. Neither did anybody else. If he heard the shot sequence right, it's impossible for one guy to do that, Davidson said. Hell, there's no way. I believe that Susie shot Dolores, and Fritz shot Janie. I'll believe it until I go in the grave. Susie's role wasn't the only thing that continued to bother Davidson about the case. He was sometimes jolted awake by dreams, in which he saw the pale, lifeless, camouflage-clad bodies of John and Jim entwined with their dead dogs in the wreckage of the blazer. Whenever that happened, sleep was usually ruined for the rest of the night. On one such night, more than a year after the boys' deaths, he got up and began to write a long ballad of the whole tragic story. It ended with these lines. 9 people are dead, and I wonder why. Especially why those 2 little boys had to die. On May 31, 1987, Dan Davidson retired from the Kentucky State Police after 30 years of service. The Lynch case had a lot to do with it, he said afterward. Seemed like, after that, everything was downhill. Nothing was interesting to me anymore. As for other officers involved in the Lynch and Newsom murder cases, in the spring of 1987, Kentucky State Police Detective Sherman Childers, Dan Davidson's close friend, was cited for bravery by the state police for returning fire after being struck by flying glass from Fritz's bullets in the Greensboro shootout. He was one of only 2 state policemen honored for bravery that year. Lenny Nobles, the young Oldham County detective, recovered quickly from his gunshot wounds and returned to duty, confident that he had learned much from his first homicide investigation. Ron Barker, captain of detectives for the Forsyth County Sheriff's Department, ran against his boss in the primary election in the spring of 1986, citing his work on the Newsom case as one reason he should be elected.